Let's talk about the divine feminine, right? Like, what is that all about? And how can we engage with that part of ourselves ultimately? Whatever form your body takes, whatever you identify as, I believe we all contain it all. And we all have access to the divine feminine within our experience as an energy or an archetype, whatever fits for you, of connection with our own being and our own, like a way of moving in our lives that can be balanced with our inner divine masculine. And again, these are a couple of archetypes of many, but there's often in my work, a focus on like kind of if one of those energies is strong, then like helping the other kind of come in strong too, as so we find this balance there. And when we have that balance in ourselves and we're able to embody either divine masculine, divine feminine, perhaps at the same time even, then we have like so much more available to us than if one or the other of those is like kind of like running the show alone, right? We're like flapping with one wing. We want to bring both our wings into the mix, right? So the divine feminine, it's a big topic. Right, it's like a big energy, and I share a bit about my journey of my own connection with the lineage of Sophia and the Sophia teachings, which is a very old lineage that connects back to like mystery schools. That have kind of been lost along the way. So the heart of Sophia, the essence of Sophia, in my experience of that energy, is the void. It is the mystery of it all. It is this womb space of like anything is possible and everything is being birthed. And so Sophia is like the everything. She's the mother and the whore in one Gnostic Christian text that I really appreciate describing her in kind of all of these ways that are like dualities in a way. And so there's an experience I have of like knowing her inside of myself. And then, like, really feeling like I have no idea at all, like, not even a clue of what Sophia actually is. And kind of holding that in my experience of that energy in my being is one of the reasons I love and am in love with the divine feminine so deeply, because there is this, like spaciousness to her that is unknowable, unnameable. And in that process of like holding the mystery, holding that I don't know, there are some other energies that have come in alongside to help me like deepen and learn more about the divine feminine by this name, Sophia. And again, I'd like to give credit to my dear beloved mentor, Kate Siner, for supporting my journey with opening to this part of myself and really introducing a way of coming into connection with Mary Magdalene as a doorway to knowing Sophia and the Sophia teachings and that lineage. And so Mary Magdalene, If you were raised Christian, maybe you were told that she was a whore, that she was, you know, kind of this sinner that Jesus saved, right? That's like a common narrative, a story, and it's a distorted story about really the essence of Mary Magdalene and her connection and relationship with Jesus Christ. And so there's a lot of mystery around that connection too, of like what was going on with the two of them, and we don't really know, which is a beautiful part of the story. But Mary Magdalene is this like essence, and I've found my kind of way of connecting with her as a woman who lived on earth is through her connection and my connection, the shared point of the lion and the energy there. And so she is like as a woman, what I understand about Mary Magdalene is a fierceness and a queenliness, that there's a way that she moved in the world that like really demanded respect, and that the teachings that she was offering during that time when Christ walked the earth as well were deeply related to Sophia and these mystery teachings that were part of the mystery schools. And these mystery schools, the understanding is, go back to ancient Egypt. And when Isis was also walking the earth in her embodiment as a human, as a divine being here. And so there is, you know, way back kind of like thread that can be connected to. And I've had visions of kind of like the void, like darkness, and then like a thin red thread kind of like coming like through like near my heart, this line, very very thin, very small red thread. And in that image kind of encapsulates a lot of what the divine feminine feels like to me. It's just like this vast spaciousness and darkness of like the not knowing. And then like this like point of connection, this like lineage that's been forgotten and is being remembered. So on your journey with the divine feminine and your exploration of it, ask for, you know, images to help clarify like what it is for you, right? That's my image, like not mine, like I own it, but that's like, you know, an example. Right? But you get to ask for, like, how can you find those points of connection? And whether, you know, the name of the divine feminine is Sophia, right? Or Isis, or Brigid in the Celtic lines, or Yemaja, or Oshun in Brazilian and West African traditions, or, you know, Kuan Yin, Green Tara, more in Asia, whatever the lineage is, right? That whatever name the divine feminine is, you know, coming in as, you can invite curiosity around like what is that the frequency. And I love, I have to say it, every time I say frequency, another dear, dear mentor of mine, Shona Holmes, says, free queens see. And that is, again, the essence of the divine feminine, like being free to be a queen and to see in the dark, right? In the void, in the mystery, and to trust our intuition, to trust our deep knowing, whatever is wanting to like come through our own embodiment of the divine feminine within us. And so invitation to play here, right? And to you know, receive guidance from a lineage if that fits for you, or to simply inquire about the archetype within yourself and the different versions of the feminine that live within you, and how to balance that with the beautiful divine masculine that's available as well in those archetypes that, of course, are more directly linked with Christ consciousness. And in this way, we can have within our experience, it's like the divine feminine as a river and the divine masculine as the banks, holding that river, you know, allowing that movement, that flow in our lives. And yet it's held and it feels safe to be in the mystery of the current and that movement. And so that's, again, another image that really fits for me. Try it on for you. See how that feels in your body, to play with that a little bit. And thank you so much for honoring all the parts of yourself.